The bird was busted. She buried her nose in no man's land a half mile due west of where I went down. Wilson, the poor sap, didn't make it out. But that was his bad luck. I had more pressing problems.
Scheißarbeit. Meine Füße bringen mich um.
I'm just gonna say I've had plenty of practice moving quietly. Out the back of bars, bedroom windows, you don't need the details. Anyway, once those Germans were gone, I put my skills to work, heading west towards the British front, quiet as an alley cat. Between me and the British front were German trenches and German guns. Oh, and half the population of Berlin, all spoiling for a fight. My lucky day. The Brits must have been sitting down for tea and crumpets instead of shelling the Germans. Still, I had to get through to our side of the line before those guns started up.
Stirb, du Mistkerl!
Those trenches were packed full of the Kaiser's finest. But hopefully, most of them would be looking for trouble coming the other way. Hopefully.
Du weißt, wenn es hier jemand liest, schiebst du bis Kriegsende Doppelschichten.
Nein, so ist das nicht. Ich schreibe eine Geschichte, ein Abenteuer.
Das ist... Hä? Was war das für ein Geräusch?
Hörst du schon wieder Dinge?
Das sieht scheiße aus.
Das ist dermaßen langweilig.
dozen German machine guns at my back kinda encouraged me to keep my head down. No Man's Land was a maze of barbed wire, dead bodies, and debris. But I held my course. Did anything survive the crash that might be useful?
You're not George Rackham, are you? Son of the fourth bloody Earl of Windsor. How naive do you think I am?
Let's get out of here. Losing a lot of blood. I didn't have much time to get him back alive.
Really bloody hurts.
The Germans aren't really known for getting back.
Cease fire!
Wilson said I was a no-good, lying son of a bitch. I brought him home because I think he's probably right. And I hate that fact more than I can tell you.
That man through no man's land? This guy's a bloody hero.
No, he's nothing of the sort. He's a cheat, a thief, and a liar. And he'll answer for his crimes. That's right, Blackburn.
To the farm, are you?
I'm gonna speak up for you, you know, at the court martial. It might do you some good.
I doubt
good.
It, but thanks.
Wilson, with me, I need a gunner.
Over here, I'll do it. Bracken, let me help.
You don't deserve to fly.
Wilson, if I'm gonna die, I'm gonna die up there.
Come on, let's do this.
You sure you don't want to sit this one out?
Not a chance. You owe me a bloody medal.
All right, I got this. Are you with me?
Of course I'm bloody with you. Fighters on their way. I'll cover our tail.
Well, it'll make for one hell of a story. Ah, shit. Bombers incoming!
The bombers are the threat! We have to take them down!
Thank you. I'm gonna die up there. You and your big mouth.
You okay?
I'm okay. We need to take out that flat gun.
Okay, I've got your back.
Alright, we gotta get up there.
Don't look down, alright?
Alright.
Just don't bloody look down.
We gotta get the flat gun.
This is madness! That gun is knocking seven shades out of our lot. We have to grab it!
I can't really see. Just straight ahead. Whoa!
Careful!
They're firing at us from everywhere.
Moving.
Come on, let's do this.
I see him. He's over there.
That's the guy.
Hey, you okay?
I'm good. I'm okay.
Find a way back up top. I'll head around to the flat gun.
Okay, I've got this. Come here. Down. Every German on this damn balloon's gonna hear you.
Thank you.
That's my story. A selfish man who risked his own life to save another, and in doing so, found he was saved himself. Things get mixed up in wartime, though, and you'll probably hear other versions. A rogue pilot who stole a plane, who killed his buddy, then lied, cheated, and murdered his way across half the Western Front, only to escape court-martial in the chaos of an air raid. But don't listen to any of that. What you heard from me is the truth. I wouldn't tell you if it wasn't. Would I?